What's up, everybody? The 78 Gemini here. Hope everybody's having a great day. And welcome to my 151st video, which is titled With a Special. The only thing special about it is you guys. You guys are what make my video special. From all the comments, the likes, the sharing, the favorites, you know, that's all great. Thank you so much for your support. I probably wouldn't be here if it wasn't for you guys pushing me and giving me the great feedback and the interest in my videos. We're going to be doing two builds and two tunes. These were both subscriber requests, one for the Lexus LFA in R3 class, which is this bad boy right here. And then we had another subscriber request on this Lamborghini Gallardo for S class. So I'm going to be providing you with both builds and tunes and just give you some information about the cars. But I'm going to be showing you a clip really quick, which is my first video ever on YouTube. Oh, and here it is. As you can see, it's really bad quality because I used a webcam to record this straight off my TV. And this is when I was online. And just goes to show you the interest I had in starting a YouTube channel. But this video is a message. As you can see, I am bumping this guy off the track in this Camaro. I was spectating him for two races before I even raced this race. And some of you might not agree with me and the attitude that I have sometimes. But this guy was just reckless, knocking people off the track to get in front of them. And I don't tolerate that shit. It's not how it's done. You know, you want to win a race, and if you're good enough, you don't have to be bumping people off the track to get in front of them. You know, if you're that good, you just go around them. But I wish I had the previous race where this guy was just being reckless and knocking people off the track so you can understand my attitude. But, you know, I'm not trying to be a father figure on the track or any type of figure in that sort, but I just, I don't tolerate it. So if you people think, you know, bumping people off the track is the way to go, I suggest you learn what racing is about. I'm not pointing any fingers or anything, but I don't know, I just I hate that shit. All right, anyways, also I'm gonna be talking about myself just a little bit, because I've been getting questions like, are you a drifter? You should do drifting videos. No, I'm letting you guys know now, I am not a drifter, and I don't drift. I might drift just for fun, nothing serious, but it's something that I'm not gonna be uploading because I'm just not a drifter. All right, so here we are. We are doing the build on the Lexus LFA. And pretty much what you're gonna be doing is installing all the race upgrades with the max tire for the front and maxed tire for the rear. I went with the lightest rims, well, one of the lightest rims with the Dymag rims, one of my favorite rims, excuse me. You get to see inside what's going on. You get to see the brakes. So I kind of like that. We also upgraded on the rim size for the front and rear. I noticed it gave me a little boost on the PI. But like I said, this is supposed to be for R3 class, and it was just shy 2 points of 800, falling at 798. So I couldn't get to the full 800. And I don't know, maybe I should have went lower than 798. This thing is a monster. But I did my best tuning it. It's not that great on turns, but it's manageable. It's really fast on straights. I tuned this for Indianapolis GP, and this thing reaches just about 2 miles per hour, 200 miles per hour on the straight at Indianapolis before you start braking. So it's a monster. On turns, like I said, it's okay. I did the best I could with it. Just be cautious with second gear. When I tune and race, I usually tune and race without any assists. So even with the traction control off, this car is manageable. Just gotta play with the throttle on some turns. All right, here's the tune. I'm not gonna be reading everything to you guys, because I'm just gonna be ranting, venting, you know. I've been having a pretty bad week. And just been busy. That's why I haven't uploaded in, 4 or 5 days. Just catching up on a few things. And my ex-girlfriend's father, Luis Cano, has passed away 2 days ago. So I've been really down and bummed. And, life sucks sometimes, but it's the way life is. We all gotta go one day, right, guys? So, while we're here, we got to try to make the best of it. You know, respect your parents. Respect the people, respect you, respect your friends. I don't know, it's just, I've been kind of lost, but my friend, I will truly miss him. He was a good guy, he was strong, he was a strong little guy. He was Gallego. For the people that don't know what Gallego is, it's a region from France called Galicia. It's a mix of the Portuguese and Spanish language, which gives you the name Gallego. He was like a father to me. He was there at a point of my life where I didn't need him. And, he was there. He was there, open arms, and always willing to help. And I loved him. He was a good guy. But I don't know. Enough of that. I don't want to really get upset here. But I hope you guys are following the build. We went with the stock rear tire width here, with the raised compound, and once again I went with the Dymac rims. I tuned this thing at Mugello full circuit. Handles really, really good. Top end, it's good. It's average. It gets me around 165 down the straight. So that's pretty good. The handling is really, really great. I went with a little understeer, a slight understeer for this circuit. I tend to turn a little earlier for these turns at Mugello, so that little understeer kind of helps me out a little bit. I think you guys will like it, but I'll let you be the judge of that. Just leave me a comment on the tunes, see what you guys think I should have done differently or something, or maybe even you guys can improve it. That'll be pretty neat. Afterwards, I'm gonna be showing you just two laps around Mugello with this Lamborghini Gallardo. Just with a different camera angles, you know, inside the cockpit, outside the cockpit, and you know, stuff like that. Just a little mix of camera angles here and there. I don't know what else I want to talk about. Oh, okay. Yeah. Well, I get asked a lot of people asking me about my gamer tag. My gamer tag is DA24 Gemini on Xbox Live. But I am offline, and I will be offline maybe for the next 2 months until I move. I'm currently in Portugal, and I'm in the process of renewing my green card so I can move back to the United States. So yes, I am a U.S. immigrant. First moved to New York back in 1985. I don't know, I just never went for my citizenship. So I came here about 4 years this April, and I exceeded my visit without returning back to the United States, so I kind of lost my privileges to return, but it's all being taken care of. That's why I haven't moved yet. I thought I was going to be moving a little earlier than I thought, but the process is taking a little longer than expected. So, I just want to let you guys know because I get asked a lot, and I appreciate the interest of you guys want to be interacting with me on Xbox Live and all that great stuff, but I can't right now. I can't. I got more important things in my life going on before I get back to gaming online. But I will get there. So all the people that sent me their gamer tags, I got them on a list, and once I get online, I'll add you guys to my Xbox friend list. All right, guys, so I'm gonna cut it here. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and once again, thank you so much for 150 videos. I hope to do another 150. Take care, everybody. Peace.